Hello everyone. I would like to show you how to make beautiful Easter eggs using a natural dye. I will use yellow onion skins, and this is actually very traditional to my family. It was passed on from generations, and my grandmother colored Easter eggs using onion skins, and then my mom, and now me. I also will try to use spinach to get a nice green color. I've never used spinach for coloring eggs, but this will be my first time. And of course, I will use blueberry. I heard you can get a really beautiful blue. So spinach and blueberries will be my experimental color to see how they will turn out. And again, onions always turn out beautiful. So for that, I do have regular eggs. And I will use rubber bands, and I will start making little designs, very simple, crisscross. Once I remove the rubber bands after they're done cooking in onion skins and spinach and blueberry, we should have a really nice contrast. I will also use something that I just came up with the idea, and I don't know how that will work, so we'll have to see. I will use a black duct tape. I have a sheet of black duct tape, and I have a little stamps to cut out pieces, and I will try to put them on an egg, and then once the color sets in, I will see once I remove them if they will turn out okay. So we'll have to see. And so here I am moving along. You can actually see how the eggs are looking. So I'm just putting rubber bands like this. That's usually the simplest way, and like I said, it actually will have a really nice contrast once we get the colors. Well, I have a few more eggs to go, and I will get back to you soon. Hello, so we're back, and I have now my eggs all done. They look absolutely beautiful, and I actually use duct tape on some of them with the designs. I have blueberry here, I have spinach here, and of course the onion. The onion is very traditional to my family. We use onion skins for every Easter egg decoration, and this is traditional to Polish side of my family on my mom's side. So let's see, I will put I'm start putting the eggs in. I only have water, so I have blueberries, no water, just the blueberries from the can. I did add water to spinach and water to onions. I think I'm gonna do the beautiful paw kind of decal in blueberry. I'll do onion here. So that's three here. Let's do this one in spinach. One, two, and three. It's all covered. So this one in blueberries. Will go to be cooked in onion skins, and I kind of like to have my stuff all covered up nicely. I know some people just like to get the dye and they will just dip the eggs. I actually found it, and actually that's what my family does. We actually cook them. We actually hard boil the eggs in the onion skins. So I'm gonna try the same technique for spinach and for blueberries. So let me start. Let's do blueberries here. Let's do spinach here. And let's do onion skins here. There you go. see how this will all turn out. Well, hello again. I'm almost done here, and I can see that I'm a little disappointed with the blueberries. I don't believe I'm gonna get the color I was really looking forward to. It's not really blue. I don't even know what kind of color is that. Maybe you're actually supposed to use fresh blueberries instead of the one from a can. And actually one of my eggs got cracked, so doesn't look too good, but we'll have to see. I know the onion ones are looking pretty good. And let me see, how about our little green eggs? No color here either. So looks like the spinach for green and the blueberry for blue didn't turn out as planned. But we'll check on onions in just a little bit. Actually, let me see. Yeah, the onions are gorgeous. Look at the color. See, there you go. So, but that's the color that's been around for almost 100 or more years. It was in our family use for coloring eggs for Easter. So I knew that's gonna turn out really good. A little bit disappointed on those two. But let me get the stuff out and I will put them on the plate and we'll see how they look. Well, and there you have. It looks like our family recipe turned out really good. We have a gorgeous, deep kind of brown reddish color. That's from just the yellow onion skin. As you can see, absolutely nothing from the spinach. No color at all. And actually, I'm very disappointed about using a duct tape. I thought it's gonna give, well, there is a little bit of distinction, but I thought it's gonna hold up very well, but it didn't. And of course, not much of a blue from using the blueberry. Let me see if I can actually take off the color. Nope, nothing to it. A little bit, well, not just a little bit. I'm very disappointed. There's a butterfly you could actually see, but the duct tape was not a good idea. It's not really coming up the way I wanted to. So I tried it. I will definitely not do it ever again because it's not looking good. So that's it. Well, let's see the color on our eggs from using the onion skin. And there you go. Gorgeous distinction of color. And like I said, the deep brownish red, it's absolutely stunning. And it's, having the rubber band, you can actually see really the difference between the natural color of a shell and then of course the color we got from the onion skin. So let's see, there's another one. Let me see, take this off. Yeah, the color is stunning. Love it. And there you go, beautiful. So again, this is the blueberry. Not really, I don't even know what to make up with that. Let me see, I'm gonna take off the rubber band. Seems there's some distinction in color. Well, looks like this. It's definitely not blue. Kind of looks like dirty marble. Yeah, I don't like this. And I will remove the others and I will show you when it's all done. So there you go, we have the eggs. As you can see, again, using the rubber band and then onion skins, They just look really, really neat and a lot better put together using the duct tape. Onion skin, gorgeous color, duct tape. I'm not getting a clean lines. It was a great idea in my head. It turned out a big mistake on the egg. This is the blueberry. Not blue, as they were saying, and the color just looks like a dirty marble. And of course here I didn't even bother to take off the duct tape because this is supposed to be green because it was cooked in spinach. There's no color at all, so it didn't take at all. And this was cooked in spinach and then it got slightly accidentally dipped into the onion skin and it picked up the color. But again, onion skin, gorgeous color, and it's just a yellow onion. Look at this. Look at this gorgeous, absolutely stunning, dark reddish brown color. I'm gonna use them for Easter. They're hard boiled. Definitely you can eat them if you want. Something you learn every year. I just know I will try something different for next year. Bye, YouTube.